the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders of
teacher. All children, there we go, all children should be with their classroom teacher. Please refer to the screens as to which side you will take your student. Thank you.
Was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they they were keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, it's grand, just holding your hand. We're gliding along with the song of a wintry fairyland. Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy cozy are we. We're snuggled up together like birds of a feather would be. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. There's a birthday party at the home of Farmer Gray. It'll be the perfect ending of a perfect day. We'll be singing the songs we love to sing without a
1 minute to walk in.
While we watch the chestnuts pop. There's a happy feeling nothing in the world can buy.
All students should be with their teacher at this time.
It'll nearly be like a picture print by career. These wonderful things are the things we remember all through our lives. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Out of all the reindeers, you know you're the mastermind. Run, run, Rudolph, Randolph ain't too far behind. Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to town. Santa, make him hurry, tell him he can take the freeway down. Run, run, Rudolph, cause I'm reeling like a merry-go-round. Said Santa to a boy child, what have you been longing for? All I want for Christmas is a rock and roll electric guitar. And then away went Rudolph, whizzing like a shooting star.
All right, teachers, students,
run, run,
give me five.
Santa, let you make it in town.
Please stand. Santa, and teachers, allow your students to enter the stage. Thank you.
Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad.
they told me, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, a newborn king to see, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, our finest gifts we bring, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, to lay before the king, pa-rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum, rum-pum-pum-pum.
Good evening and welcome to Calvary Christian School's Christmas music program. I'm Mrs. Sloan and I'm the principal here at Calvary Christian School. Thank you for joining us tonight. The students and the teachers and all of our staff have been working so hard this past couple of weeks, and so I think you're truly going to enjoy this celebration tonight. Couple of announcements. This is being live streamed on our YouTube channel, so you can go back and watch, share with your friends over the Christmas holidays. Also, directly after the program, we are selling hot cocoa and cookies, proceeds to benefit our 8th grade trip to Washington, D.C. at the end of the year. So you'll see the lobbies decorated beautifully. There's trees from all around the world, nations that are represented here at Calvary. So enjoy some hot chocolate and stroll around. Also, this Saturday is our Parents' Day Out. So we have some students that are going to be passing out flyers at the end of the program. Please enjoy a day out with your spouse, with your girlfriends, get a cup of coffee, finish your Christmas shopping, go home and take a nap. It's $25 from 10 to 3 here at Calvary. It's like a play date you don't have to be a part of. We're going to feed them. We're going to have pizza and drinks. So don't forget to register. It's this Saturday from 10 to 3 here at Calvary. All right, before we get started, let's open up in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to share your word that is truth with all of our friends and our family, God. We thank you for the students and the teachers and the staff that have worked so hard. I pray that you bless them and that you bless every family that is represented here tonight, Lord. Bless their homes. Give them favor and health. We ask that the words of this program sink deep into our hearts, Lord, and that the true meaning of Christmas goes forth into our homes at Christmas time, Lord. But beyond that, as believers, every day we experience that joy and that peace that can come from you and you alone. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Sloan. Good evening. I'm Mrs. Benson. I'm the music teacher for the elementary department here at Calvary School. And we're delighted to have you here this evening. We could feel the energy. I know you felt it. And we feel it every day, all day. Lots of energy. I don't know which side of the family that comes from, but there's a lot of energy there. And so we are going to corral that. We've been working on that for quite some time, like since the first week of school. And we're getting there little by little. The kids know little by little and amen. That's right. So practice does not make perfect. My son reminded me that. Practice makes permanent. Whatever you choose to do, the more you do it, you're not going to become perfect at it, but it is going to become a permanent. And I hope that what we do here, singing and praising, becomes a permanent place in these kids' lives. And hopefully it will be a memory for you to last you for generations. Speaking of generations, some of you sitting in that audience have been on this stage with me as a student. Wave at me if you were one of those people. There they are. I got moms. I've got moms. We have grandmas out there that were moms watching their kids, and now they're watching their grandkids. What a great legacy for Calvary for you to pass that down. So we are going to enjoy these kids up here on the stage. We have teachers in the back of the auditorium. We have them on the side. We have them in the back of the, behind the stage, backstage. We're grateful for everybody's help. I thank Mr. Shineman and the media team for helping us this evening. Mrs. Zimmerman for my right-hand helper all the way through every program for the last, over 20 years now? So we have been really, yes. And this will be my 30th Christmas program here at Calvary School. You know what? Everybody likes to be encouraged. These kids thrive on encouragement And Mrs. Sloan does a phenomenal job of reminding the kids how special they are, and they're made on purpose for a purpose. And we give them every accolade we can during the day of the week. However, you're here tonight. They're going to thrive on your clapping, your applause, all of those wonderful things that will just energize them even more to do their best, first for the glory of God, amen? And then for you, well, for me, second. And they want to make you proud as well. So be part of the auditorium, be part of the cheering, the applauding, the singing. Just enjoy tonight. Wow. Did I lose you guys back here? Hang on. We're ready to start. And now, Calvary Christian School proudly presents the first Leon.
Noel, Noel.
Christmas. Everyone loves Christmas.
But it's not about the presents or the lights. It's all about God's love. He sent his son Jesus.
And the best part is that we can share the Christmas joy with others.
Jesus, our Savior and King. His love and kindness are the reason we sing. Always for others, the people we meet.
Yeah. We know that joy comes from Jesus, and he came to earth to save us from our sins.
God wants us to share this good news with the whole world, so sing along with us.
It's Christmas. We sing because the Savior is born.
Got a lot more ahead. All right. Well, good job, everyone. That just now completes our rehearsal. Don't forget, tomorrow night are the cast auditions for The First Leon. You're dismissed.
so nervous.
I know.
Yeah, me too.
Just breathe, girls. Just breathe.
Hey, Jonathan, what part are you going for?
The lead, of course.
You mean the part of Joseph? Me too.
Noelion. Noelion.
That's Leon. He really loves Christmas. Ever since he discovered that his name spelled backwards was Noel, he's felt called to tell the world the true meaning of Christmas. So when tryouts for the annual holiday pageant came around, he figured that this was his big chance.
Hey, guys!
Leon, what are you doing here?
I'm trying out for the Christmas musical.
Look, Leon, I don't think this is the right place for you.
What? Why?
I mean, you gotta have the right look.
Yeah, and there's a lot to memorize. You have to know your part.
But I want to be in the Christmas program. I don't care if it's a big part or not.
Leon, there's like a bazillion people watching.
Right, you don't want to mess it up.
Oh, that hurt my eyes.
Well, despite all those who tried to discourage him, Leon decided to audition for a role in the program anyway. First, he started with the male lead.
All right. Leon, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, Leon, I see here that you're trying out for the part of Joseph of Nazareth.
Yes.
All right. And action.
Mary, we must go to Bethlehem.
Next.
Oh, well. Maybe he wasn't meant to play the lead, but there are other characters in the Christmas story. So, next, Leon tried out for the part of the shepherd.
Hark, I am sore afraid. What is that up in the sky?
Next.
Okay, so wise men are important in the Christmas story too. Maybe Leon could try out for that.
We have seen the star in the...
Next!
Leon wanted a part so badly, he was willing to try out for anything.
doing here? This is the angel tryouts.
I know.
Angels are girls.
No, they're not. In the Bible, they're boys. Gabriel and Michael.
But in this play, angels are girls.
Yeah.
All right, ladies, you're here for the audition for the angels. Is that correct? Mm-hmm. All right. Well, wow me. First up, Madeline.
Fear not, for behold, I bring good tidings of great joy.
Very nice. Thank you. All right, next up is Julie.
Unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior who is Christ the Lord.
Very nice. Thank you. And Brooke, please.
This shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
Okay, thank you. That was good, too. All right, and then we have Leon?
Yeah!
All right, go for it.
Glory to God in the highest, men on earth. With liberty and justice for all!
okay, all right. Thank you. Thank you very much for the auditions. That really is all the time that we have. I'm sorry we've run short on time for auditions. But stay tuned for tomorrow. We will be listing the cast. Thank you very much for coming.
You gotta have the look, you've gotta have the style. If you wanna be a star,
finally, the cast was announced. Jonathan got the part of Joseph.
Yes.
Madeline was Mary.
Yes!
All the other kids would be shepherds, wise men, angels, and narrators. All the kids, that is, except for Leon.
Excuse me, Mrs. Benson.
Yes,
can I help didn't you? Hear my name called.
That's because you didn't get a part.
I didn't get any part?
Sorry. Maybe next time.
But I thought...
Hey, Leon. I can't use your kid, okay?
Okay, I see. Noelion, Noelion.
Hold up, wait. Come back. All right. Let me see what I can do here. Well, I think I can make you, I don't know, an understudy. An understudy for the innkeeper.
An understudy? For the innkeeper?
Yeah. We'll put your name in the program and everything. It'll make your mama proud.
Wow, thanks! Hey, guys, guess what? I got a part in the play.
You did? What part?
An understudy for the innkeeper.
Leon, do you know what an understudy is?
No, not really.
It's kind of a substitute, you know, in the unlikely event that the real innkeeper gets a hacking cough, then you step in.
Really?
Sure, that's in a likely event, of course. Hey, I think the innkeeper has a few lines in everything. What are they, Jonathan?
Yeah, I say, innkeeper, please, sir, I want a room for the night. And the innkeeper says, no room.
No room? That's my part? That's all I got?
It's no big deal. It's not that big of a part. But hey, you never know when you'll be called on to step in and save the show.
Yeah. No room. No room.
Just two words, their power can be great.
room. No room. No room?
All right, places, everyone. Let's rehearse the shepherd's part. Leon?
Yeah?
Do me a favor and go move over there, please.
Sure.
Thank you.
No room. No room.
And we'll begin the narration. And action.
And there were in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
Shepherds.
A new thing?
Yeah, watch this.
Leon, I can't help but notice that you've been to every rehearsal.
Yeah, I'm an understudy.
Yes, but you know you probably won't get to actually perform.
But if the real innkeeper gets sick...
It's not likely. Maybe next time, Leon.
Okay, choir, next up is the angel song. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
And this time, please, no ad-libbing.
No, ma'am.
Joy for all ye nations rise. peace. Hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings.
Choir. Cast call is tomorrow at 6 p.m. You're dismissed.
Opening night. It was a packed house, and backstage, all the characters were getting ready for the program.
Aren't you nervous, Jonathan?
Nah, it's not really a big deal.
Hey guys, do we look sort of afraid to you?
You're pretty scary looking if that's what you mean.
Hey dude, I'll show you scary.
No, boys, no. Boys, no, you're ruining your costumes. Boys, no, please.
Hey guys.
Leon, why are you here?
Yeah, Leon, you're just an understudy. You don't need the costume.
Yes, I do. The actual innkeeper actually got sick.
What? No, you're kidding.
No way. A hacking cough?
No, a stomach virus. Good thing I came to all those rehearsals and learned those lines. Now you say, innkeeper, please, sir, I want a room for the night. And I say, no room.
Hey, Leon.
Yeah? No room.
Ever heard of improv?
No, not really. No room.
A sign of a great actor is how well they can improvise. It's a big word, I know, but it means to make up lines as you go.
Oh, okay.
Jonathan, no room. What are you thinking?
No room. All right, people, places, everyone. 2 minutes until curtain.
In those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city.
Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David,
which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
About to give birth.
Jonathan!
Don't you see, Mr. Innkeeper, that this woman is carrying the Son of God, Jonathan. The Savior of the world?
Jonathan!
All right, then. I guess we'll have to go sleep in the stable.
Wait. Don't go. Mary and Joseph, come back. You can have my room.
Just a kid, but it's all I've got, all I have to give. You can have my room, Jesus. You're always welcome here, Jesus. I won't turn you away.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Can that be our prayer for today, that Jesus can have it all? Can we all just say that one more time? Jesus, you can have it all. Say it with me. Jesus, you can have it all. And let's say it one more time. Jesus, I make room in my life for you. Let's say it together. Jesus, I make room in my life for you. What a great, great, great play. It's not even over yet, Ms. Benson. This is so exciting. Isn't this such a great time? Isn't this such a great season? Let's make some noise right now for Jesus. Let's make some noise right now. I believe that Christmas is the greatest story that has ever been told, and it's actually a true story that is being told, a real story that is told. I'm talking over 2,000 years ago, prophecy was fulfilled. This big book, my students at J-High get at me because I got like the biggest Bible. It's got some big words in here, you know, because I can't see sometimes from the stage. But what's great about this book is that it is a fulfillment of prophecy. Every word in this book right here is true. And what's great about Jesus Christ is that he came in, while as I'm watching Leon, it kind of reminds me how Jesus came in so humbly. He came in on, and he was born on a manger. Jesus came in a way where people didn't even realize that this is the King of the universe right here in front of our eyes. And so I want us to think about this and let this be a season. Let this be a moment to realize and remember the greatest gift ever, which is Jesus Christ. We are here because that Jesus Christ is born. And what's great about Jesus Christ is that when he lived his life, Jesus Christ, he died and he rose again. So that way all of us have a way back to the Father. Back to the Father. So Christmas, let this be a moment that we reminisce on a time of the greatest gift. Let us reminisce on that despite of what we go through, that Jesus Christ has paved a way for us to have eternal life and eternal life with the Father. So let's take this moment right now and let's just reflect. And let's just think about the greatest gift in Jesus Christ. And before I go into to a salvation call, I want us to know that if you don't know who Jesus is, he is here for you. He is alive. He is living. And he is still here ready and willing to take you and to save you. It says this in Romans that if you confess with your mouth, and just like the song, if you believe in your heart that he is the Son of God and that Jesus Christ was risen and from the dead, that you will be saved. But you have to say it with your mouth and believe in your heart and you'll be saved. So let's take this moment. Everybody repeat after me, if you're so willing. Say, Jesus, come into my life. I am a sinner in need of a Savior. I believe that you are the Son of God, that you have died and risen again for me, and I believe that I will spend eternity with you. In Jesus' name we pray. And we all said, amen. Amen. Thank you, guys. You have a wonderful night.
The rest of the program went on as planned. The angels sang, the shepherds kneeled at the manger, and the wise men entered on their cue. Please join us in singing Joy to the World.
Thank you.
is wonderful. What a great night. What a great program. You guys did such an amazing job. And Leon, thank you. What a great job tonight.
Wow, thanks.
Thank you.
Leon, you are awesome.
Me? But I messed up.
No, Leon, you made the show.
Just two words, no room. Leon, the lowly understudy for the innkeeper, knew what it felt like to hear those words himself, and his heart went out to the newborn Christ child. He'd gotten caught up in the moment, but everybody knew that Leon had uncovered the true meaning of Christmas. Everybody else had just pushed Jesus aside. But that night, Leon made room for the real star of Bethlehem.
He didn't have the style. He didn't have the moves.
And ladies and gentlemen, that concludes Calvary Christian School's Christmas program of 2022, the first Leon. What a blessing, amen? I always tell the kids that I start doing this in the summer, floating in the pool, listening to Christmas music. I'm still doing it during the school year. I'm waiting on God, what he wants the message for just a time as this. For what we need, what I need, what they need, what you need, what we all need. And when God lays it on my heart, it's a go. And we knew this program was a go, didn't we, guys? They got to vote on them. They were a part of it. And it was just a tremendous opportunity to select the first Leon. Auditions are tough. I heard you. You were booing me. In the play. I had a parent, you're out there. Somebody texted me not too long ago and said, oh, I want to send you this video. My child is playing Mrs. Benson at home. I was like, okay. I was afraid to open it. I was like, okay. Because you guys know Mrs. Benson is Mrs. Benson. That's it. But I love your kids. If I didn't, I'd be doing someplace else. Doing something else, but I wouldn't have it any other way than to be here with your kids, with our kids, with God's kids, amen? I want to thank all of the kids. We got little kids that are learning to sit still, and that is a tough deal. So give those teachers and kids a hand on the sides. They did an awesome job. We have all of our speakers and our singers and our actors. Wave at us, speakers, singers. They're everywhere. We have our angels and our super cool shepherds. We have our wise men, Mary and Joseph, and a humbling heart, Cody Reynolds, Mr. Leon. All right. Now, cast, I'm going to dismiss you to remove your costumes. Go ahead and you're dismissed. We are going to dismiss tonight. Just want to remind you that we do have the hot chocolate and the cookies and all the treats. The auditorium is here to collect your kids. And then after that, enjoy the Christmas trees. Enjoy fellowshipping out in the lobby area. Lots of great pictures to be taken out there. Your students will be picked up right now, and I'll dismiss you to get them on each side. And then as you exit the building, please be very careful in that parking lot. Did you know that today was the longest day of the year? Yep, I heard that. 4:21 was sunset. Some of us come to school in the dark, and we go home in the dark, don't we? We do. You go to work that way as well. But good news, today was the longest day. So every day thereafter won't be as long. All right, but it is dark outside, and we don't want you to have any kind of accidents with kids running around in the parking lots. Keep your kids with you. Don't let them run. Bring them back to school tomorrow. We can't wait to share the love of Jesus and more things to teach. All right, I would like to dismiss. Go ahead, third grade, take us off. Fourth grade. If you have a child in junior kindergarten, they are over here just waiting for you to come and tell them what a great job they did. Kindergarten is on your left. Be sure to collect any and all kindergartners. Do not collect anyone yet other than those two grades. If you had a cast member that was in a costume up here on the platform, you will be able to come and pick them up right here where I'm standing in just a few moments. All right, we are now ready for first grade to be collected on your right, second grade on your left. As soon as you have your child, please enter into the lobby. Open up this auditorium. We have third graders on your right. We have fourth graders on your left. We have fifth graders